Hey guys, welcome back to Caveman Mining. I hope everyone is well and having a great day. On today's video, it's going to be a quick one. We are going to discuss and go over some testing on the new NBMINER 40.0 for the light hash rate unlock, and we'll go into the logistics a little bit about the miner and what changes and enhancements they have made. And without further ado, we will jump right into the laptop and get in here and check it out. Okay guys, so we are in the laptop now and we're going to take a look at NBMINER. So let's go ahead and remote into our test bench. And ironically, as we are filming this, I did a refresh of the release notes site on GitHub for NBMINER. We were planning to do this NBMINER version 40.0, and then they just released a hot fix for false detection of LHR under NVIDIA's latest driver versions. But we won't have to deal with that because we ran the version 40.0 and we did not have any issues with LHR being detected. But what I wanted to do is just quickly go over what the update on the miner is. And essentially all it is the same as the previous versions, but in Windows, we now have the ability to add overclocks in as arguments for custom settings, such as setting our power limits, as you can see here, and we can set that in watts or in percentages, which is quite nice. And we can set the core clock in as well, which we can see there. And we can set locked clocks as well as memory clocks and selected core voltages, which is pretty cool. Fans and a couple of other features I won't really dive too much into here, but we have the light hash rate lock detection failure on some cases that was fixed in this version. So this is going to be a quick video because we have this up and running and we've been running it for quite some time, but I did want to show you guys what the batch file looks like. If we take a quick look after everything is extracted, we are presented with a new batch file called start f overclock. And if we go ahead and right click and edit to look at the details of that, it starts out with the top line for a change directory and a couple of arguments there. And then it has the NBMINER, the traditional minus A ETHASH, Stratum server, plug in our wallet, dot worker, dash log. And then I put in the dash light hash rate, dash mode one, dash log, and then space power limit. And I did 66%. So this is weird, but it's got a double percentage. For some reason, that's how it's coded. I tried to run it with the one single percent and it didn't work. The other thing I wanted to do is I wanted to run this at 65%, but I noticed if I did 65, it was actually running at 64%. So I don't know if anyone out there has actually run this yet that can confirm that is an issue or a bug. But if I set this to 66, it does keep it on 65, what I want. And then the core clock, we have it at 1530, and then the memory clock at 1300, and our fan at 78%. So with running all that, it's pretty consistent in terms of the hash rate from what we were seeing on the previous tests, which is pretty good. So we are running mid to high 35. So we've got 35.66, 105 watts in the software, an efficiency of 339 kilowatts, kilohash per watt. And yeah, you can see we're still hovering around the mid 35 range, which is what we had before, 338. Kilohash per watt at 105 watts in the software. So a little bit better in terms of the software watts. Now at the wall, if you guys take a look at the bottom right hand corner of the screen, we are bouncing a little bit, but we're in between the ranges of 146 watts to 157 watts, just bouncing between that 10 watt range. You can see in the software we spiked up to 112 watts, but we got up to 35.84 megahash, so almost getting close to the 36 megahash range, which I don't think I've actually done with any of the NBMINER versions. We actually did break the 36 megahash range in the T-Rex version, which was pretty cool to see. So, but this is clearly doing much better in terms of efficiency. You can see 341 on that kilohash per watt. So much better, I guess, watt management or power management on this version of NBMINER. So, you know, not getting that crazy jump in hash rate, but hey, we'll take it. Just wanted to jump into what to mine and take a look at the profitability of this 3060 Lighthash Revision 2 card. Based off of the clocks and the power that we are running at the wall, and again, this version of NBMINER is 40.0. So we had a hash rate of 35.66, and at the wall we were pulling about 145 watts. So if we just do a quick calculation on that, that brings us to $2.24 after the cost of electricity, and $2.59 before the cost of electricity. So pretty consistent in terms of the profitability that we have been seeing with all of the light hash rate miners, from low miner to G miner to MB miner. So I think we've made still made pretty good strides from, you know, where things were in the beginning. I remember, you know, just barely being able to get 30 mega hash when these light hash rate miners first came out. So pretty on point. Hopefully we can increase the profitability before Ethereum is no longer mineable. But for now, you know, we'll stay hopeful. I'm not gonna drag this video out any further, guys, but I appreciate you all for checking it out, and we'll see what is in store next for these mining journey and discovery. Who's going to do something next? Is it going to be NBMINER, T-Rex, LOL, or GMINER? We're eagerly awaiting to see. But if you like what you saw, guys, hit that thumbs up, smash that subscribe button, and we will see you on the next video. Caveman Mining, take care.